there is the confirmation of what I've just told you, which is that China are 2 alarm up in this Group A tie. Group A, of course, because China are the number one seeds for this Thomas Cup campaign. 11 finals they've been in Thomas Cup competitions, having won the trophy and lifted that magnificent Thomas Cup 9 times. But 2 years ago, as Steve was telling you, they lost in the semi-final stage to the eventual champions, Japan. Also happened to be in the same group here in this year's Thomas Cup competition. Japan, the number 5 seeds in Group A. China, the number 1 seeds. France qualified for the Thomas Cup competition here as the 13th ranked qualifying country. So Lin Dan, the 2-time Olympic champion, 5-time world champion. He's up next against Luca Clairbaud. And of course we have the second men's doubles and 2 scratch pairings from both China and from France. And then we finish with the third men's singles. And another left-hander for China, Tian Haowei, beaten finalist at the All England Championships, where he lost out to his teammate Lin Dan, the man we're about to see on centre stage. Now, of course, at the group stage, if you've been with us yesterday and certainly during previous Thomas Cup competitions at the group stage, you must play all 5 matches within the tie. And the reason for that, of course, is that if 2 teams or even 3 teams are tied on the number of ties won and lost within the group, then you look at the number of matches won and lost within the group. So it's important that all 5 matches within the tie are concluded. Once we get to the knockout stage, and it's just the top 2 teams from each group that qualify for the knockout quarterfinal stage, from then onwards, we do not contest any dead matches within the tie. So as soon as 1 team has won the required 3 matches within the tie, any remaining matches are not played. Now just listen to the reception for Lin Dan. And what a moment for Luca Clairbaud, a 23-year-old from France. Lin Dan, 32 years of age now. Can he create history in Rio? No badminton player has ever won 3 Olympic titles in consecutive Olympic Games. Of course, we've had players win 2 gold medals at 2 consecutive Olympics. Not only the man himself, of course, because if he's going for 3, he must have won 2 already. But the first players to retain an Olympic title, Steve? Women's doubles.
The women's doubles.
Yep.
Wow.
Gefei and Gu Jun.
They won in 96.
And again in
2000. Okay.
I believe so.
Yeah. And then Jiang Jun.
Yes.
2000 and 2004.
With Gao Ling in the mixed doubles.
Yeah. Gao Ling, did she win the women's doubles as well? No.
No.
No. That's only Zhao Yunlei who's won
2 golds in one,
Olympic
Games.
Olympic game.
So there he is, the man himself, the 32-year-old former world number 1, currently number 3, born in Fujian in China. Actually born in Longyan near Fuzhou in Fujian province. Luca Clairbaud, from the port city of Bordeaux in southwestern France. They do make a lovely drop of red wine in that area of the country. 23 years of age, just below his highest ever world ranking, which was achieved in March earlier this year. Now, they did play each other in the last Thomas Cup campaign in Delhi. And as you can see, Lin Dan was also in the group stage, incidentally, and won in 26 minutes. 21-5, 21-11 now, Steen. I know you've just been looking at the matches from Delhi. Was that at second men's singles, or was it third men's singles? I think it was third, wasn't it?
I haven't checked that.
No, okay. I do beg your pardon.
Yeah. We could have that one of the players that were above Lindan at that time, that would be Dukun or Chinlong, was given a rest that day, but I haven't checked it. But
And of course, France had Brice Lovedes.
They had him playing
In Delhi, didn't they? He's not made the trip here to China this year, but he will be competing at the Olympic Games, Brice Lovedes.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, China, represented by Lin Dan. 7-11. And on my left, France, represented by Lucas Verbo. France to serve, Favon.
So France's Claire Ball on the side of the court getting this second men's singles underway. Now, just to explain a little bit, and the reason why I keep emphasizing first men's singles, second men's singles, first doubles, is you can't play out of your ranking. So the highest ranked player selected for a tie must play at number one. The second highest player selected for a tie must play at number two. So you can't suddenly throw in your second ranked men's singles selected at third singles. You've got to play in your ranking order.
Yeah. There is, however, this little twist to it, that if, for instance, China feel that feel that Chinlong is not really up to playing, for instance, Sungwon Ho of Korea, that he's not been showing his best of form here, and they're playing him late in the tournament, they could rest Chinlong and put Lin Dan in first men's singles.
Absolutely.
Chen Ho Wei in the second, and who's the third? The fourth player, he could just
play,
but Chao Bien, yeah, he could play the third men's singles, but that would take some kind of nerve to do that.
Yeah, but so as long as the player is selected for the tie, they must play in their ranking position.
Yeah.
So if Chen Long isn't selected, of course the other
they move up.
They all must move up one place.
I just checked the 2014 edition. It was the third men's singles.
Yeah. The start of this match, Lin Dan, but then I've thought that on several occasions lately. He's been a little bit sluggish at the start of a match, but it's not how you start, it's how you finish. And he's been playing very well this year, hasn't he? Well, what year hasn't he been playing well? That was a daft thing to say, wasn't it?
No, not really, because I don't think he played particularly well in 2015. He won tournaments, but
yeah,
but didn't play as well as I would expect him to do. And he's been playing really well in the beginning of this year, winning German Grand Prix gold and the All England, of course. And judging from those two tournaments, looking a strong contender to repeat his Olympic gold. But then we saw him in some other matches where he was, in my opinion, a little bit unimpressive. And I mean, 95% of the players would still love to play the way he did there. But it's just when it's Lin Dan, we hold him to higher standards.
Yeah. Should also mention a third tournament that he's won this year, which was the China Masters Grand Prix Gold, where he beat Chen Long in the final. And so, therefore, your theory on, you know, whether he's in his mind and other people's minds still favourite for the gold medal in Rio.
Yeah, he's got his experience going. And he's got the two medals that's back home in the draw. That's also going for him because, I mean, I don't expect him to be nervous in Rio, but almost anyone else will be quite nervous. But he's had, in my opinion, he's had trouble the last 2 years. He's had trouble on a special type of players. Whereas other players he's just disposed of as he normally did for many, many years.
Yeah. Now I would keep lifting to Lin Dan's deep forehand corner there.
That's
dangerous. Here we go. There's the clear down the forehand side. Thank you very much.
He's totally in the other corner. He can't see what side he's hitting it in. And that just... It doesn't go just for Luca Clerbeau. Look at his legs. Every time Lin Dan has time in his long forehand, when he can put deceptions on his shots, look at the opponent's legs. They're going to be shaky.
Yeah.
But yeah, the scoreline 6-6. Pretty respectable start from the French. What was that? Was it too fast?
50-19.
So if the serve is too quick, just put up your hand. Hit that again. And we've seen Lin Dan be some kind of frustrated with people flicking him. The same goes for the coach on the other side, Peter Gehle. I mean, why don't you serve short service so I can make my normal return? We saw that again there. No, that was caught.
Yeah, above the waist. Henrik Boas, the service judge, making the call.
First game won by Chinese striker, 21-15.
Yeah.
That was too short.
That was too short. I bet he wishes he hadn't said he wasn't ready.
Actually, I feel that when Lin Dan is playing at a high pace, he makes fewer mistakes than when he plays at a low pace.
Yeah.
Oh,
that was going point, wasn't it? Surely.
this. Beautiful. Beautiful.
A little look and a little word with his coaches at the back of the court. And Dan obviously hasn't completely got his spatial awareness. Ah, now, what's that? He's saying there's a bit of wind, there's a bit of drift. That back in. Can't say I've particularly noticed any sideways drift. Have you, Steen? Might
no,
be a little
I
bit.
But we're sitting in a very bad position to pick up on
yes.
sideways drift. We're mostly looking at the court without looking at our monitors. And in order to pick up the side drift, you have to be precisely behind the court. So
yeah.
See if we can pick up on some of that. But I mean, it was quite far in from the side.
Yeah, so the big game interval with a three-point advantage. Luca, clear ball. It's a nice change of pace, I do like that. Not an awful lot of eye contact there between Lindan and his coaches.
Still
talking.
The
coaches are sitting in their chairs.
Service judge to just keep an eye on his serve, and he shouldn't be allowed to say that, but it can be perceived as intimidation.
Yes. We had the same situation when he lost to Jan Jorgensen. Was that in Malaysia? Yeah.
The final stage.
He lost in Malaysia, lost the third game, really big, and he sort of got frustrated with the services of Jan Jorgensen.
It was actually the second game.
What was the second game?
21-4.
Yeah, 21-4. Okay, so it was just a two-game match, yeah.
Yeah.
That's right, my mistake. Well played. Good shot. Excellent shot by Lucas Clerbout. Exactly what's needed when Lindan tried to play you in your forehand side. You need those cross smashes. They're dangerous to make and you hate to make them because you got to run and you got to cover your backhand side after that. But that's the solution. Lindan is clever. He plays a lot of shots to the opponent's forehand side because he knows he's going to get a lot of shots back in his own forehand side where he can control the match. He can use his deceptions. And you got to get out of that trap. A cross drop, quick cross drop is also usable. And the thing is that if you clear cross and you clear too short, Lindan, he's so fast, he picks up speed, makes his lethal steep smashes, but only if it's too short. He's got the same tired look as Chen Nan had.
Yeah.
Or do I really have to play this game? And this is also what we discussed. There's no free points. There's no free points. Lucas Clerbout, he's seen two Europeans at least beat Lindan. He's seen Tommy Subiato beat him. He's seen... who else has beaten him?
Someone Ho. In India.
So he believes in his chance, and as long as Lindan is playing at that pace, he's going to give him a real run for his money. And the coaches, they can actually just say to Lindan, hey, you decide yourself how many games you want to play. Yeah. I mean, if you want to win this match, you got to raise the pace.
Yeah.
Again, all the dangerous things from Lin Dan is coming from his long forehand side.
Yeah. That Lin Dan hasn't come out firing on all cylinders. I know that he's 32 years of age now, and perhaps he likes to work up within the match more to his top speed or whatever. But I mean, you've just made a very interesting comment about, well, Lin Dan won't get nervous in Rio because he has two Olympic gold medals in his pocket already and so on. And I'm just thinking,
maybe
you know, if you struggle in matches like this and you don't put the fear of every other player by getting out there and blasting through a match like this, there's a danger you will get nervous in Rio.
And at least you're going to face tough opposition. And maybe, I mean, maybe winning a third gold is just as big for you as winning a first gold is for all the others. So
exactly.
There is some percentages that are the chance that Lin Dan still could get nervous.
Yeah.
But the thing that it's hard to win when you really want to win, when you've lost so much. And one of the best examples that I've been close to was a Danish world champion, Camilla Martin. Mm. When she played her last Olympics in 2004, she lost to Tracy Hallam from England. And all credit to Tracy Hallam, because she reached a quite good level.
Yeah.
But she shouldn't be able to beat Camilla Martin. But Camilla had lost so many matches. There was no confidence left when push came to shove.
Yeah.
And Tracy Hallam, she believed in it. She played her chance.
Yeah. Yeah.
So.
And this is one of the things that you alluded to a little earlier, because Lin Dan has now lost to, I was going to say so many players, but a number
it's
of
not
players.
That many.
It's but a number but of players that other players, all players, now believe they have a chance.
Yeah.
That aura of invincibility has gone.
And the game plan has been executed by more and more players, and it's becoming more and more obvious what needs to be done.
Yeah.
But then again, I must say that the way we saw him play it, especially the All England, that was that was more like it. That was the way we like to see him play.
Yeah. Yeah.
And there's also this that, I mean, he's won so much. So, I mean, first round Thomas Cup against the team where we're going to win the team match no matter what. I mean, perhaps it's hard to get yourself out of the bed in the morning for a match like that. Perhaps you need something higher at stake to get the same feel that, hey, this is going to be fun. I'm gonna do my best and see if I can manage.
Yeah, that same adrenaline rush.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, what can Lin Dan gain from this match? He can't gain anything. Even if he went 21-0, 21-0, he's like, yeah, Lin Dan won. He's great.
Yeah.
He can only lose.
Yeah. There's the danger from the deep forehand corner again. Just watch his movement here. Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
Look at that. It's just
he's
glides.
Threatening. His whole body language is threatening with a smash. And then a very, very controlled slice drop. Beautiful. And now, Luca Tebbel, now you're in trouble because...
They're both in trouble as far as the umpire is concerned.
I would suspect him to be in trouble playing-wise because now he's got Lindan at an even score with 5-6 points left in the game. So I think he's going to up his pace now. That's a good smash because I was just thinking, hey, you're playing too nice now, Mr. Klebu. You're not threatening anything, but that one was well timed. Going to get called back to, oh, there he moves his towel. if you have a towel hanging out over this box that you have your gear in, then you get called back. You can't have a towel hanging out. There it would have been nice if Klebu had waited for that forehand lift because some of the other top players, they know that this is coming, so if you wait for it, you can make that cross match that's going to most likely be a winner.
This opening game is far, far from a foregone conclusion. Credit to Monsieur Clairvaux. That was nervous to me.
And it was way too close to the net. There was nothing to gain from that unless it had tumbled over. One more. 19, and this is where Klebu should tell himself it's really bad if I don't win this game. Because he'd been playing better in the first game. Too short. The stick smash is there.
That's right. It's the match so far. Let's bring up game point. For China. And then two game points to be precise. Game point well saved. surprised the umpire allowing Lin Dan to towel off.
Big gaps in Lin Dan's backhand defense when he's playing at a pace like this. When he plays faster, he can close down. It's not a big as big as it is right now, but
yeah.
There's a huge advantage if he just smashes to his backhand side at the moment. Good service.
The following match and court three will be the group stage of Europe Women's Doubles, Chinese Taipei vs. USA.
Chen Xiaoguan, Xu Yaqi,
I think Peter Gere is doing a little bit of footwork for himself on the chair there.
I noticed that. Yeah. Twitching because his player's about hitting him in the shot.
Good shot. A little bit of the pace out and hit it a little bit quicker.
Yeah, crisp, wasn't it? Nice angle. So having just saved two game point opportunities, now Luca Clerbaud has a game point opportunity himself. No danger. Oh, he's missed it. He's missed it. Opening game to France.
It's a beautiful shot.
It was amazing. And Luca Clerbaud has taken the opening game against the two-time Olympic champion. Amazing.
Yeah.
25 minutes. Yeah, one game to the goods.
Okay. Please. You see, we need to stick to plan no matter what happens. I want to see you stick to plan, okay? From the back, no hard smashes. Trust me, okay? No hard smashes. We use the stick. We use it on the middle. You can sometimes stick him on the middle, yeah? And the angles. That's what we do. On the back, you play him in the backhand side all the time. Okay? Of course you can.
Chinese coaches working hard, still talking to their man. Peter Gaylor has already left the court, having given his advice to Clerbaud. And the advice was no hard smashes from the back of the court.
Yeah, I can see the idea about it, but I actually think that he can kill the hard smashes on Lin Dan. It's important to show him that he can come through him. He's playing with the drift now, and that gives him an advantage. So I think once in a while he can hit full power to the body or full power to the backhand side.
Yeah, Peter Gaylor did say if you're going to hit, go down the backhand side.
Yeah, exactly, and that's really clever.
Yeah, that's way in.
Yeah. there's a problem for the Chinese coaches now, because what they really need to do, I mean, there's some issues. Maybe Lin Dan is not feeling well, or he's a little bit injured or something. But if that's not the case, then he needs to be told off. He needs to be told, this is not good enough. I don't care how many gold medals you've won.
Yeah.
You're on home soil, and you're about to lose to a French guy who nobody here in the hall knows. No disrespect to him, but it's just there's so big level difference between these two players. So the coaches, they need to tell him. How else can you take your call?
That is so one, four.
And you're giving me a look.
I'm just thinking, my goodness, I'm glad you weren't my coach, because that sounds harsh. But you're right. You see, I was just absorbing what you were saying. And you're absolutely right, because there's me saying earlier, Lin Dan's been winning matches on reputation. Forget the reputation. You've got to go out there. It's your last match.
And it looked like he's feeling sorry for himself.
Yes.
Why is the umpire not calling this service? Why is my opponent not giving me any more easy points and so on? Come on, stop whining and play.
Yeah, get
the
on with
we
that.
Know you can play.
Yeah. He looked a little bit sluggish and starting the match. And already, I know it's early stages of this second game, and I know he's just lost that rally, but I'm sensing that he's trying to up his intensity.
He's trying to, but it's hard, and I think the two Chinese coaches, they need to be a little bit more active now. Now he needs someone cheering for him and saying, come on, that's exactly what we need.
Yeah.
That's the right pace. And sort of, they got to work even harder now, because he needs their help.
Yeah.
They're good.
It's going to be difficult for Pepe because he's playing with drift.
Yeah.
So he's going to have trouble controlling the shots to the baseline. And that's a major concern, in my opinion, for him. Because it will force him to probably attack a little bit too much and perhaps play a little bit too short in the backhand corner, giving Lin Dan a number of opportunities for his steep smashes.
Yeah, there's the towel hanging out of the kit box, what you were talking about during the opening game.
So all the players, they know that if you want a little bit of an extra break, just leave the towel hanging out.
Yeah.
More concentration now.
Yep. There was a couple of times in the opening game, Steen, that I wondered about Lin Dan's movements to his backhand net. He didn't look particularly comfortable in that movement.
No, but I think that's because he plays at such a low pace at the moment, and he can't pick up that quick extra step that he needs.
Yeah.
So he's also going to struggle if Clairbou or any other player from his forehand side can play the reverse slide straight, if he can play that close, he's also going to struggle unless he raises the pace of the game and starts moving faster on an overall basis. But again, we must remember that there could be something physically troubling in that we can't see or don't know about. But
thank you.
taken, isn't it? Good follow up. Look at that.
There's no quality in the defense.
No.
Good shot.
Again, he's talking to his coach, and his gestures there is a little moan that the service fault wasn't called on his opponent. And the more I think about it, Steen, the more I'm concurring with you.
Guess what the players, when they watch video, guess what they're putting in their notebook? Flick them down.
Yeah. Yeah.
Run, challenges.
Screen. Yeah, it was out. Yeah. That's, I guess, a bit risky to challenge that far side of the court from where you're playing from when it's with the drift as well.
From table one. There, when he plays the cross clear, he sort of utilizes the drift a little bit in order to get it long enough.
Yeah. And it was good height, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Played with sort of holding a bit of deception as well, punching through the shot.
Yeah. Yeah. Very good.
Beginning to get on Lin Dan's back. Or am I reading too much into that?
I don't know. Someone was cheering Jayo and come on. Better meet. Must be disappointed. He's a game down and struggling a little bit in the second as well.
Yeah, that movement.
Yeah.
On his backhand net.
Good shot. Good shot. It's wide.
But the idea was.
Yeah, the idea of putting variation in from every part of the court. Because Lin Dan is perhaps the best in reading opponents. Reading patterns in their game.
Yeah.
Well played.
Yeah.
That's too clever.
Yeah.
That's too clever.
Yeah.
But the forehand corner, the short forehand corner, and the long backhand corner from Lin Dan, that's the weak spots at the moment.
Yeah. His authority on this second game, but oh, that sounded in. But every time, and all credit to Luca Clairbault, he comes back. Well, he has done so far.
Three,
Well, it's definitely a first of the tournament match for Lin Dan, but yeah, we know that he can be a whole different player tomorrow. If
yeah.
I don't know if China's playing tomorrow, actually, but there's still one group match left.
Yeah, it's actually on Wednesday yes. against the defending champions, Japan. So. Silence right now. 10-0.
Good hide on that lift from Klebo. Not possible to make the steep smash. Great net play.
Yeah. So it is Lin Dan who has the advantage of the game interval. Is just one solitary point.
Stick to this, okay? Sometimes he's going to try it. The variation now is when we use his backhand corner, sometimes we need to use the short drops, okay? Yes? And you're doing it, but you have to keep doing it. We can use his body. Just do the stick on the body. Sometimes from a, you can do that. Use a short drop and use his backhand corner. That's what we do. We're doing so good. Stay tough, stay cool.
Stay tough, stay cool. And what was the technical, tactical stuff there, Steen?
Yeah, it was something about using the short drop. I don't know. Exactly, whether it's a cross drop, which I would, from there he needs to drop either straight or cross. Either one of them is good, but otherwise, the coaching was really great. Not too much, he's doing well, and he's playing, he's having the game of his life here,
yeah.
So he can't, have too much information, just let him play.
Mm.
Reinforce him in what he's doing is right and make him do it.
Oh, he got to it, but couldn't control it. It's always fascinating, isn't it, for us as spectators? I know the way you watch a match like this, because you can't switch off from your coaching role and you think of it in coaching terms, but you know, for me as a general sports fan, of course I'm a fanatical badminton fan as well, but you know, I see some players playing against a legend like Lin Dan and they look intimidated by the prospect. Claire Bowl is looking inspired by this opportunity,
exactly.
And I like to see that in an athlete. Oh, look at that!
And he's saying when he comes home, he's like, yeah, I played Lin Dan. I don't understand all the others. What's the fuss about? I mean, it's a good match with him. There's nothing much. But there's two. It comes in two different issues, Lin Dan.
And they're poles apart.
Yeah.
There's no middle ground.
No. And this is also where the experienced coaching comes into play. Spot the weaknesses, massage them, exploit them, keep doing it, make the opponent make another move. Otherwise, just do the same.
Yeah.
That's too short. Yeah. And whenever he deviates from his game plan, Klebo, he ends up in trouble most of the time.
Thank you.
match yet.
Yeah.
Well played. Excellent play. But also well played from Dan.
Right.
And Shashwansi scratching his neck.
Surely a player of Lin Dan's experience would never underestimate any opponent, surely.
Mm.
Do you think he's just come into this sort of... maybe there is something wrong. I mean, he just doesn't seem to have the attitude that I expect from Lin Dan.
I think he sees this as a boring game.
Well, it might be so boring. As far as the world of badminton is concerned, if a player that an awful lot of people won't have heard of, they will certainly remember the name.
Yeah.
In future, Luca Clairbeau.
He's been in control the last 8 rallies or so, Lin Dan. I still think he's got things under reasonable control here, unless he's extremely unlucky the next 2 or 3 rallies. He's playing a little bit too safe, Clairbeau. I'd like to see him attack a little bit more. Choice.
Yeah.
High cross lift to the backhand side.
2 points away from the second game. Lin Dan. Game all, 21-14, second game to Lin Dan, China. And Chinese fans can breathe a sigh of relief.
Yeah.
Just
Yeah, we can't hear what's being said. There was something about a deceptive drop shot there. Like he gave us gestures.
Yeah, in retrospect, the drop shot thing didn't really come into play. He's not clever. He's not winning this match at the net. On the contrary, we've seen him make a couple of mistakes when he's tried to play too close himself. So, play the net, but don't go for the points there unless you're in real big problems, because then you need to go for the 50-50 chances.
Yeah.
Perhaps a bit more variation to the forehand. He can play then down to the forehand side when he can put pressure on him. So it's not too obvious what's going on. That's an important rally, this one. There was the mistake again.
Yeah.
And when he looks back at this match on video, he can isolate that area around the front service line and say, okay, from here I played too many shots that I had no chance of winning. I just played them into the court or tried to make a neutral shot, but I missed it too many times.
So, just to clarify, Steve, that attempted little cross-court net shot is preferable to just playing it safe. Is that what you're saying?
I'd rather that he just lifted to the back court, because okay. I don't think he's got any advantage over Lindan at the net. It's more the shot that Lindan made there. He's not really close to the net. He's a little bit below the tape. And that's the shot where Klebu, on a number of occasions, has tried to play the net, and it's been a mistake most of the times. So I think the audience is about to be over. I think Lindan is going to take this third game convincingly.
Ooh. 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 I didn't like that. I did not like that. Ooh, it seems to be nice. That was a nasty, nasty slip. Now he looks at the bottom of his shoe. Now the problem is when you slip in that lunge position, hamstrings, Achilles. Ooh, no, I didn't like that.
We've seen you a couple of times.
Yeah.
You get your heel cap knocked on your Achilles.
Yeah. And of course, we had that horrible, horrendous injury at the European Championships with Ivan Sozanov.
Yeah.
Actually rupturing his Achilles. Last thing we need is another serious injury. Well, it's sad to see it any sport in any time. But he's playing so well. I do hope he's all right. Yeah. Peter Gaeder's a little bit concerned. Are you okay?
Careful.
Yeah. Yeah. Be careful. Yeah. We all echo that.
Very rarely a game-ending injury slipping forward compared to twisting your ankle. But the day after is not fun.
No. And look how his knee went down as well. extending the knee.
This is the best rally they had played all day.
Yeah.
Now he's picking up a bit more speed and his game comes together.
Matthew Nottingham, Harley Tyler, England.
Lying there like Lee Chong Wei, watching whether Lin Dan would be able to retrieve that one. Or maybe more likely whether it would come over the net.
The following match in Court 2 will be the group stage of Eurocup women's singles, as you are the technical officials.
Oh my goodness. Claire Bowl was...
Now let's welcome the players.
Oh, yeah, trying to get out of the way. We saw that in the men's doubles, didn't we?
Japan. Ivan Lee, Germany.
There's a little bit too little variation from Claire Bull to my taste right now.
I wonder if that's come about because of the definite instruction in the second game. You know, trust me, don't smash from the back of the court. And he's got it so clear in his mind that, you know, he must play the softer shots or whatever, and that he's forgotten about the variation.
Yes, that's a possibility because, I mean... It's always, there's a sort of a code between the player and the coach. And when I say 80%, do you actually know what I mean? And, and then suddenly after some months or so, you find out that, okay, the player doesn't mean, it doesn't know what I mean when I say 80%, or at least they don't interpret it the same way I meant it. And that could very well be the case here that that Peter is sitting. He played the forehand once in a while.
Yeah,
but you told me I should play the backhand, so I played the backhand.
Yeah,
but I meant you should play it more often than the forehand.
Yes, yeah. Oh, look at that. That is delightful.
And that's the first time today that we've seen a shot like that from from Clever One. And that's what I mean. If you play too simple, it will be too easy for Lin Dan. So you gotta put some variation into your shots. And
four. Words of wisdoms can leave the gate and impart to his player here. Look at that. Isn't that just poetry in motion? Such an athlete.
Okay. No change, Luca. We need to still do the same things we are doing. Be so disciplined about playing his backhand corner. Now the sticks are really good. That's the key. Keep using the stick with good speed, okay? Yes? Okay. When we play the backhand quarter, ready in defense. Keep changing the shuttles. Keep using the flick also. He might fold you, but yes. Okay?
Definitely seemed to stick to the game plan there.
Yeah, that's understandable.
Yeah. I have been impressed with Claire Bowl because, I mean, I think I verbalised in the opening stages of this deciding game, I thought the bubble was burst when he was 6-1 down. He's stuck with it, though, hasn't he?
Yeah, actually, it looked like he upped the pace and played a little bit more freely because, okay, now I'm not playing to win anymore. Now I'm playing exactly like the first game. I'm playing to challenge him then.
Yeah.
And there he was, pushing at the net. Being behind 12-6 in the third game against Lindan, you would say, no way.
Yeah.
It's gone. But, yeah, it might be. In most cases it is, but there's still a slight chance.
Challenge.
Good call by him, Dan. In my opinion.
So you thought it was wide?
Yeah, I think so.
Yep. Well, one of the things Gator said was don't be afraid to challenge.
Yeah. Dan is one of the players that's got the best feel for where the court is according to drift and everything. Of course he can make misjudgments as everybody else, but this time.
Just toying with him in that rally.
Yeah. For the instruction book, just repeat it twice. That's how to do it. Was the same shot Chin Long made in the first match.
A good effort there. Clear ball.
There'll be lots of things to take back to Paris and say, okay, I need to improve in these areas here. These areas are actually quite good, but here I got to be a little bit better. Positive match for him. Just a match for Lin Dan.
Yeah, but apart from being able to analyze and say, yeah, well, I need to improve that and so on, it's a great measure of an encouragement for what you've already been working on.
Exactly.
Because you don't often get these opportunities to play against an Olympic champion.
Right.
And you can say, look, I took him to three games.
I scored my own points.
Yeah. And everything I've been working on is paying dividends now. Let's keep going. Let's improve more things.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Right, drop shot from the net. That one. If that had been Klebu executing that, that would have been a huge chance that it would have been a mistake. But Lin Dan, no, he's got the touch.
Yeah.
No, that's more like it. That's more like it.
Match points have arrived.
Match point.
The Olympic champion.
4-2, 30 seconds. 4-2, 30 seconds.
Yeah. First time of asking. And Lin Dan gives China a third point in this Group A tie. But he did it the hard way. He had to come back from a game deficit. 1 hour and 7 minutes needed.
21-14, 21-8.
Yeah, umpire confirms the scoreline. Well, Claire Bull has done himself and his country proud today. He may have lost, but my goodness, he gave it his all and he played extremely well. But their confirmation, Lin Dan winning a third point for China in this group tie. 20-22, 21-14, 21-8. In the deciding game in a match lasting 1 hour and 7 minutes.